Pai, cada vez que tu aprende a fazer noite com o Senhor, de noite com o Senhor. I thank you, God, in the name of Jesus, for the impartation of the anointing. Thank you, God, for the anointing, oh God, to draw. I thank you, God, in the name of Jesus, oh God, for the heart to search out the Word of God. To make the Word simple, oh God, for those that need to hear it. I thank you, oh God, in the name of Jesus. That God, in the season, oh God, that you have him in, that you are opening doors. Thank you, God.
Right.
Yeah. These hands. For these hands in the name of Jesus, that whatever they touch, it shall be blessed.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Right.
I thank you, God, for this fire of God that's in the man of God. I thank you, God, for the ideas. For the ideas, oh God, that you have given him, oh God, to advance ministry.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus. I thank you, oh God. In the name of Jesus.
Yes,
for those things that he's seeking you for.
Yeah.
I thank you, God, for your yes. I thank you, God, for your yes. I thank you, God, for your yes. Your yes in the season of God, where doors are opening, God. Your yes in the season of God, where you're advancing him in the things of God and in the words of God. I thank you, God, for advancement in the ministry.
Yes, Lord
Jesus. In the name of Jesus, for the heart of a pastor.
Yes.
May not necessarily be a senior pastor, but God said you have the heart of a pastor, a heart to look after people, a heart. God said, I'm giving you this heart. I've given this to you. God said, even as you begin to walk and hear me more, God said, understand that I have your back. I have your back. Pastor, can you come to Pastor? Hallelujah.
Woo-hoo!
Pastor! Pastor, praise God. If I can't get this, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. That's a dynamic anointing. That's what I can feel. That's what the dynamic anointing that's upon you. There is a earth-shattering anointing that's in this. Is this your church, right? Can y'all come up here? All right. Can y'all come up here? Man, all right. I feel the release of God. Here we go.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Everybody pray. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. So what God's saying is, there's an earth-shattering anointing that you guys have. That what you are about to embark on, people are going to talk about you and say that y'all don't know what y'all are doing. You got the old guard. The old guard that will step in and say, stop, young man, stop. You don't know what you're doing. Let me teach you. But God said, I'm showing you a whole other way. Just Brother Drake, Pastor, what happens is that we get into the traditions of men in church and we think this is how it works. We think that this is what we're supposed to do. But God said, no, I come in different ways. I love when Miles Monroe was talking about the jawbone of the donkey.
Yeah, yeah.
And he talked about the reason why he had him throw away that jawbone was because he don't want us to get used to doing the same thing over and over again. So you question, and I understand why God had to call you up to the question. You question, God, am I stepping out in the right season? Am I doing what I'm supposed to be doing? And he sent those to walk with you to let you know, yeah, you're doing what you're supposed to be doing.
Amen.
You're walking in the anointing of God. You're walking in your season. You're walking in your season.
And what God is saying with these right here, God said, these are pastors. That's gonna help you draw the folk in to the ministry. Come look for your ministry, Justin. Are you from Detroit? Are you from Detroit area?
Nobody.
Your ministry is just not located in nobody.
Oh.
All right.
Woo.
God assumed this vision. God assumed this vision. I need somebody to pray with me. I need to know the power of God. It's not just in nobody.
Woo.
But you stepped out and you did some stuff that people have been afraid to do.
Come on.
God told them to do some certain things, and they've been afraid because they don't want to be talked about.
Yeah.
God said, I'm passing up those folks and going to a group that's not afraid. That's not afraid to be different. That's not afraid to look different. That's not afraid to speak different. That's not afraid to walk different. But let's look at those people. So you did a faith move.
Woo, Kenzie.
Because, and I'm talking to you too, God has challenged each and every one of y'all with some faith moves. And God keeps telling me, he spoke to you specifically to do some stuff. It was a faith move. You knew it was going to cost you something.
Come on.
Yep.
But you did it.
Yep.
You did it. Even when moving from other locations, God said, you did it.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. I ain't
did it.
Woo.
Yeah. Okay.
You did it.
Okay.
Let me get it. And I said, because you did it,
go ahead. You
God
get
said,
closer.
I am going to increase your life. And that's why you have to have hands on your hands, because everything you touch with them, God said, I don't want you to be worried about your finances.
Yes. Come on, Jesus.
I don't want you to be worried about that. God says, so I'm giving you ideas to increase your life and increase those that come at you because you trusted me. Lift up your hands, man of God, and receive every single thing that God has asked you.
Thank
in
you,
the
Jesus.
Name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
Pastor. God is changing my ideas and stuff right now.
Yeah.
God's changing my ideas and things right now. I always thought it was weird, Pastor, when I saw, and forgive me, but I thought it was weird when I saw older people calling a younger pastor father.
You gotta be in the spirit.
I'm like, man, if I turn 60 and my son becomes my pastor, I'm not gonna call his father. I'm gonna be his father and he's gonna be my pastor. But God's changing my distance. Why? Because God has given you the wisdom of what he got. He has given you the wisdom of ages. You have the ability to go into the Word, right? And pull out stuff that people have never seen. You have the ability to do that. And God said, because you yielded and because you gave your heart to me, God said, you threw yourself into me. God said, I'm throwing myself into all of your business.
Amen. In the name of Jesus, let it be done so, Father God. Let it be done so, Father God. And come into the great name of Jesus.
This is a multiracial ministry.
Yeah.
I see you, Father God.
Yes, Father God, in the name of Jesus, we come into an agreement, Father God.
I've seen people that have disconnected from
Jesus.
and it hurt your heart. It broke you. You didn't understand why. You didn't understand it. And when I said, well, just because, and I know we gotta go home, but I just, can I miss my time?
Keep going, please.
Just because Paul got knocked down, it did not mean that he was doing something wrong. Just because you will get knocked down the life of the shine, it does not mean that you're doing something wrong. Sometimes the right decision will separate you from the wrong people.
Amen.
Don't look for, and let me go with you real quick. No, don't look for joining denominations.
Right.
Don't, you don't need their money. You don't need it. God was saying, because I don't want you under their control.
Amen. From the beginning.
I want you under control.
That's good.
That's how I am going to provide.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
There are kingdom financiers. Do you have your vision written down? You have it written down or you understand it? Just start to pass it out to people. Just start to tell folks this is what I'm trying to do. God is giving you specific people. I don't know. It's people that everybody can't get to. We watch them on TV sometimes. The people that everybody can't get to, God's giving you specific people to give this vision to. And knock their door down. Knock their door down. Knock their door down. I'm excited to see where you are in 5 years.
Amen.
I'm excited about your life. I'm excited about your life. Listen, y'all. Enjoy these quiet moments. Enjoy these moments where people don't know y'all. All right?
Jesus!
And enjoy the moments where you can go to a restaurant and people look at y'all as just another person. Enjoy these moments when they're about to talk to y'all.
You don't know what's going to happen after this.
Enjoy these moments. Because as an apostle, we establish to move forward. So we set him up in the city that he's supposed to go to. We set him up in the city that he's supposed to go to. We set her up in the city that she's supposed to go to. Understand that this is what God has called him to do. Don't be upset when he can't answer your call all the time because he's established ministry.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I stand in the spot, kind of like a Matthew Stevenson. But then I see it when you establish ministries. Where God has not just given you a heart to establish ministries, but to establish pastors. So God, I thank you and I praise you.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
I'm almost done. But the number that you need, God for, God, if you want to walk this thing, if you want to get this, I need this amount of money, God says it's coming. I'm giving it to you because you did with so many men and all of itself, my men,
Jesus,
you can tell them what they are afraid to do, what they refuse to do, what they would not do. So God said, because of that inside, you're blessed.
Amen.
You're blessed. One more done. Got you. One more done. Evangelists.
Thank you, Jesus.
Prophetess. You know what? I can't stand when people say prophetess. Prophet.
Go closer.
Prophet. Prophet. And really, yeah, I don't know what that was.
But the reason why God is affirming right now, God is affirming right now, you are the prophet, you walk in the office of the prophet, you can't sleep because you're a prophet, you can't sleep because you're constantly praying and interceding, you can't rest because it's all on your heart, you should see folks, you gotta pray, you gotta fight for them, and then they got that spirit in you that just wanna fight you, and you see injustices, and it bothers you, it irritates you, it aggravates you, it makes you mad to the point that you come to tears, that place right there, even with your own family, where you see some
Jesus, come on, Holy Ghost.
Stuff, it has hurt you. God said, if he's right there, God said, it hurt you. God said, if people said they can get hurt about stuff that took on, they ain't no need to be hurt about. Because there is, because on the inside, there's this anointing on the inside that is bothers you when folk are going along. You are God, by said, take hold. So you are called to speak
McKenzie.
Against nations. I'm going to say that. Specifically, she's called to speak against nations.
Come on, Holy Ghost. Come on, Holy Ghost. Come on, Holy Ghost.
Jesus.
You better be in the spirit.
Called to speak against nations.
You better be in the spirit.
And sometimes I read the Bible. Developing the whole part about the prophecy is, you got to speak against the nation you live in.
That's right.
Come on, woman of God.
So the stuff that they have to prophesy against the nation, they have to go through with them.
Rabakurotoboshi,
Rabakurotoboshi. You said some things out of your mouth that made people mad because it was the truth of God.
Yeah, Lord. Yeah, Lord.
You operate with no filters. And you try to get this. And God said, no. That's not how I created you to be. Be who I made you to be.
Yes,
see,
Lord.
Be who God has made you to be. Don't be nobody else. God. The land. You got to pray for that land. You see, ministries that start, maybe, you know, they've been around for 20 years and they still came. But no, that's not y'all.
You better be in the spirit. Back up, back up.
What you see? And it wasn't out of the same. And sometimes, Pastor, you know how it is. Sometimes we prophesy about people and go home and like, man, say what was right. Did I do what? Man. I felt stupid.
That was just
me. Yeah. Well, God, you do with God, all right? Well, I'll be the better God.
Hold on.
I'm about to be done after this. Somebody, I'm proud. I got a breach.
In our church, we go as long as the Spirit lead. I know this ain't ours, but. Here, go to your mommy.
I feel a sense of that you've been looking for your match, right?
Come on, Holy Ghost.
You know, when you joined up with the man of God, you felt that release or that relief, your match in spirit, okay? And then even God says you kind of made up your mind that I'm going to let them try some things and do the things of God, right? And God said, I've been watching. I'm watching your prayer time.
Yes, sir.
I'm watching your study, your intercessor.
Yes, sir.
You pray. God said, the anointing of prayer is upon you. The anointing of miracles. You use people lay hands and see miracles.
You are the spirit.
The desire for miracles. The desire to go back and minister for folk and bring them to God. That there's a drive, there's a fire in you. How about that? I think, can y'all be about to keep praying? Teacher, can you pray with me for a minute? There's a fire in you. An unquenchable fire. An unquenchable. It's like a quenchable thirst. It's driving you. It wakes you up. Man, I wish I had somebody like this in the midst. Man, there's a fire in you.
Yes, Jesus.
Can I say this too?
Yes, Jesus.
I'm searching. I'm looking.
I get it.
But when she comes, she's going to help her with the ministry.
Right.
Alright? This thing, man, this thing you can't do by itself.
Yes, sir.
You're gonna need the help.
Yes, sir.
You're gonna need the help, she's gonna be there for you. This woman of God. This woman of God. I see her singing. I see her being a worshiper. I see her being a worshiper. I see her just worshiping God. Even I just believe God, even right now, this hour, she's worshiping God because of her love for God.
Yes.
It's going to match her love for God.
Amen. Yes, Lord.
I'm going to call you.
Yeah.
I just want my family to be saved. I want my family to feel what I felt when I accepted you as my Lord and Savior. Because this thing feels good.
Yeah.
Your family.
Jesus.
I said, y'all work this thing.
Jesus.
Y'all work this thing. Amen. God, your family. They are going to join you in ministry.
Come on, Jesus. Yes, sir. Speak that. Speak that.
They're going to join you in ministry.
Speak that.
I said, so don't trip. They let them talk about you. Let them say whatever they want to say about you serving God. Let them say, because God said, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess. And God said, you're going to see it. God said, it's not going to happen at the end of this world. God said, you're about to see this thing. You're about to see it. So God,
yes,
in our praise, in Jesus' name, brothers. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My joy for Jesus was so good. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.